Good afternoon. In this session, we shall be dealing with the refund procedure. To understand refund procedure, we'll have to go through certain provisions of export of goods and services, because refunds under GST regime are allowed only under exports and in inverted duty structure. Exports we'll understand, but what is inverted duty structure? Inverted duty structure is a system in which our inputs may carry 28% tax and our output may carry 18% tax, thereby meaning the rate of input, the rate of tax on our inputs is higher as compared to the rate of tax on our output supply. In that scenario, due to blockage of credit, the supplier can go ahead and take refund of that credit in form GSTR3. Export of goods and services under GST regime. Now, we shall be covering definition of export of goods and services, procedure for export of goods and services without payment of IGST by submission of LUT oblique bond, refund of IGST paid on export of goods and services, refund of input tax credit paid on input tax credit on goods and services for export wherever person has done based on LUT oblique bond, and provisions for refund of ITC on the on goods and services, ITC thereby meaning input tax credit, and refund forms and duty drawback. Duty drawback, a scheme which was functional in pre-GST scenario, has been modified to a great extent in the post-GST scenario. So, it will be important for us to understand the duty drawbacks. Export of goods, meaning the taking the goods outside India from a place in India. Export of services means supplier of services located in India, recipient of services located outside India, place of supply of service is outside India, place of supply as determined in terms of the section, the relevant section of IGST Act where place of supply is defined. Payment of such services is received in convertible foreign exchange. This payment condition is there for services while this condition is not there for goods. Supplier and recipient of service are distinct persons. You cannot be the same person. If you are the same, that thereby meaning that if you have a branch office outside India, that service provision of service to a branch office outside India will not be treated as export of services. Zero rated supply. Now, a special relief has been given wherein the supply of goods and services or both while in an export or to a SEZ developer or to a SEZ unit can be done on the basis of zero rated supply. Persons, we'll skip this, and there is a notification 37 by 2017. Eligibility to export under LUT can be, this facility can of export under LUT has now been extended to all registered persons. Earlier this facility was limited to people who were exporting more than 1 crores in a year, but now this has been extended to all people except those who have been prosecuted for more than 2.5 crores of evasion, 250 lakhs, more than 250 lakhs evasion prosecution which has been initiated against any assessee in past 5 years. In that except those cases, anybody can file LUT and avail without payment of taxes, he can do exports. Validity of LUT, the LUT shall be valid for a whole financial year in which it is tendered. Time limit which is specified for export of goods is that the goods are not exported within time, the facility of export under LUT will be deemed to have been withdrawn and tax on those supplies will have to be paid. Documentation, self-declaration to that effect that all conditions of LUT have been fulfilled, and based on this self-declaration, the LUT can be furnished. LUT is to be submitted prior to export, including export from SEZ by a SEZ developer or a SEZ unit, and LUT oblique bond should be accepted within a period of 3 days on its receipt, along with self-declaration by the exporter. And if LUT oblique bond is not accepted within a period of 3 days from the submission, it shall be deemed to be accepted till the time it is rejected. We will be skipping the this is the form for filing this. export, because these are procedural rules, may not directly impact you, but refund of IGST paid on export of services. IGST will first be paid on export of services. I am now talking of cases where you have not furnished LUT or bond, but still you are entering into an export transaction. So you will have to first deposit the IGST on and thereafter claim refund. Now when you deposit IGST, say you had a 12 lakh rupees of input and your output liability is 15 lakhs, then 3 lakh rupees you have to pay in, through cash ledger, while the refund amount shall be entire 15 lakhs. That means the entire input credit can be adjusted while payment of export of goods. And we have to submit the details in GSTR 3B and GSTR 1. And refund of IGST paid in case of goods shipping bill filled by the exporter shall be deemed to be the application for refund for IGST paid on goods, while the person in charge of the conveyance carrying on the export goods are required to file export journal manifest. And once they file export journal manifest, the refund of IGST paid on goods would be applicable after the supplier has filed a valid return under GSTR 3 and he has included those transactions in GSTR 1 pertaining to this GSTR 3. In case of service, refund of IGST paid on export of service can be claimed in GST RFD 01, and refund of IGST paid on goods shall be applicable to the available to the applicant on furnishing of GSTR 3. That means the service providers will have to file an additional form in the form of GST RFD 01 to avail refund, while the goods manufacturer GSTR 3 in itself shall be deemed to be a refund application. Export under bond or LUT without payment. Now, once you have furnished a bond under form RFD 11, then manually to the jurisdictional officer till the time the form is available online. RFD 11 is not available online as of now on the portal. You have to submit the details in GSTR 3B and GSTR 1 for export of outward supply on zero rated basis, and the refund of unutilized input tax credit can be claimed in GSTR RFD 01. Now what will be the amount of refund? Refund in case export under bond / LUT, as per the formula, the refund amount shall be equal to the turnover of zero rated supply of goods and the turnover of zero rated supply of services into the net input tax credit divided by the adjusted total turnover. The refund amount means the maximum refund that is admissible, and net ITC means the input tax credit availed on inputs and input services during the relevant period. Now, turnover of zero rated goods, turnover of zero rated supply of services, adjusted total turnover. Adjusted total turnover is important. It means the turnover in a state or a union territory excluding the value of exempt supplies other than zero rated supplies during the relevant period. And relevant period hereby meaning the period for which the claim is to be filed. Now, illustrative example. Turnover of a company is say 10 lakhs. Zero rated supply without payment of tax in July is say 6 lakhs. Now, turnover of exempt supply is 1 lakh. Now, ITC availed in July 2017 is 50,000 and refund is 33,000. How? 6 lakh is the turnover of zero rated supply into 50,000, the total ITC, divided by rupees 10 lakh, which is the total turnover, less rupees 1 lakh, which is the exempt turnover. So, 6 lakhs into 50,000 divided by 9 lakhs, thereby taking it to 33,000. Another example where ABC is in Haryana paying IGST on export, supply of value of goods is 5 lakhs, IGST on export product is 18%, IGST payable is 90,000, your input tax credit which has been availed is 40,000, net IGST paid is 50,000, so refund will be 90,000 which was chargeable on IGST payable on supply. Now, conditions for refund of export of goods or services. Exports not subject to export duty are only liable for refunds. That means on any export of goods where there is a duty of customs on export, there cannot be a refund of GST. Claim of refund to be filed within expiry of 2 years from the relevant date of the export. You can't file the claim of refund beyond 2 years. So if you have not taken refund up to 2 years, then the refund cannot be taken. It can only be adjusted as an input tax credit against other output liability. Relevant date based on mode of transportation different for different export services. After submitting form GST RFD 01, the proper officer shall within 15 days scrutinize the form and submit the acknowledgement in RFD 2 in case of service export. And no refund of input tax credit shall be allowed if the supplier of goods or services or both avails a duty drawback in respect of the central taxes or claims refund of integrated taxes made on such supplies. Exporters claiming refund should not have been prosecuted for more than 2.5 crores in past 5 years, and in case he has been prosecuted, then his refund application shall not be processed along with other refund applications, while his refund shall be processed within 60 days as per the normal procedure, because this procedure of expeditiously provisional refund within 7 days, 90% refund is being given. This is followed in case of exporters where the government has some trustworthiness, and even for small evasion the government has not put that condition so that the exports can be eased out. The refund amount shall exclude any amount of input tax credit which has been provisionally accepted. What are the credits which are provisionally accepted? The credits where your suppliers have not furnished those details in their return, while you have claimed that the supplier has supplied those goods to you, those credits you cannot take refund till the time the supplier confirms those as valid credits. Acknowledgement for refund for exports to be issued within 3 days, 90% of the refund amount to be granted on provisional basis within 7 days, and balance 10% within 60 days. So when you will get balance 10%, at the same time the people who have defaults of more than 2.5 crores, they can also get their refunds subject to the conditions which the commissioner may enforce. Cases in which are delayed more than 60 days, in case there is any delay, they will get interest at the rate of at a notified rate which will not be more than 6%. Refund forms RFD01, where the application has to be filed, RFD02, where the acknowledgement for filing application has to be issued, RFD03, where deficiencies have to be pointed out, RFD04, where the officer has to make an order sanctioning the amount of refund on a provisional basis, that means within 7 days refund we are talking of, RFD05, where the officer gives advice that the money has been credited to your bank account, and RFD06, the balance 10% to be given on scrutiny of document in form RFD06, sanctioning the balance amount of refund. Duty drawback. The facility of all industry duty drawback and brand rate duty drawback to continue. The drawbacks under section 74 will refund of custom duties as well as integrated tax and compensation cess paid on import of goods which are re-exported. For exports during this period, exporters can claim higher rate of duty drawback, that is the composite AIR, subject to the condition that no input tax credit of CGST / IGST is claimed and no refund of IGST paid on export goods is claimed and no CENVAT credit is carried forward. While SGST word is missing here, that means SGST credit can be claimed. A declaration from the exporter and a certificate from the jurisdictional GST officer in this regard has been prescribed in the notification related to AIRs, and this will prevent the double availment of the neutralization of input taxes, and exporters shall also have an option of claiming only the customs portion of AIR and claim the ITC as per GST laws. So he has an option either to claim the higher composite AIR or claim the lower duty drawback as per this option, which has been extended for a period of 3 months. Thank you so much for a patient hearing. With this, we close the procedure of refunds under GST regime.